each other. Next door is only a footstep away. Neighbors, everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Another. That's when good neighbors become friends.
Yeah, if
body needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Neighbors should be there for one another. That's when good neighbors become friends.
Mr. Skiros, is there something wrong?
I want to see my daughter. Where is she?
I've no idea. She certainly isn't here.
Well, where then?
I don't know. Madge,
Mr. Skiros, what are you doing here?
Poppy didn't come home last night.
Well, I can understand your concern, but really... Yeah,
but where's your son-in-law?
Scott. He's in bed, I imagine. Why?
Poppy went out with him. She didn't come home last night.
Yeah, well, I'll go and wake Scott. Perhaps you can shed some light on this.
Mr. Skiros, come on, sit down. I'm sure Poppy's up safe and sound.
I hope so. She's an innocent girl, you understand?
Yeah. I'm afraid Scott isn't here. He doesn't appear to have come home either.
I knew it. I knew it. They go out for a picnic and they stay out all night.
What's worrying me is they might have been in an accident.
Oh, now, don't go jumping to conclusions,
Madge.
I'll
check the hospitals. Mr. Skiros, why don't you go home in case she turns up there?
Yes, good idea.
No. I stay here. My wife is at home. I tell you, if there has been no accident and this Scott has taken advantage of my daughter...
Well, considering how much food you've packed, there's only... One bread roll left. I think it's all yours.
No.
Fair's fair.
Look, we haven't exactly starved, you know.
Well, we might soon if we don't get mobile. How's your ankle?
Oh, a bit better.
Have a look. Still not too good, is it?
Well, I'm sure I can hobble along if I have
to. No, you are staying right here.
Yeah, okay, but we've got to let someone know where we are. My father will be freaking out by now.
I'm pretty safe in that department. Harold and Madge won't even be up yet. I'll head to the service station and ring from there.
You said the phone was wrecked.
Well, the station will have one. It'll be open by now. I can get the tyre fixed at the same time.
Hey! Woo! Here!
All right.
Yeah. Woo! Can you give me a lift to the service station?
All right.
Oh. You gonna be all right?
Sure, go.
At last, the sleeper awakes. Some coffee?
Yes, sir. Jamie's sleeping in?
Yeah. Still in dreamland.
How'd you get on with Jane last night?
Okay. Did you manage to get in the mind of things?
Not for you mean?
Well, yeah.
Well, to be quite honest, I didn't really make much progress. She was pretty lively to start off with, but then she sort of... quieting down by the end of the evening.
I don't know what to do about it.
I think the best thing for you to do is just give it time. I mean, it's bad enough that you're both living in the same street, you know. She's never going to escape you. She'll just keep bumping into you everywhere she goes. It's going to make it hard for her to forget.
I don't want to hurt her anymore. I don't want to lose contact with her either. I just want to be friends, if we can.
Yeah, I think you're asking a bit too much.
Hello? Yes, yes, I'm still waiting.
Another cup of tea, Mr. Skirish. No more tea.
Bye-bye.
No news, I take it?
I checked all the hospitals and the police. Nobody knows anything. Oh, I'm so worried.
I am too. If this boy hurts my Poppy...
Skouros, they could be lying injured somewhere. That farmhouse they were visiting is miles from anywhere.
He has taken her away. My innocent Poppy. I killed this son-in-law of yours.
Now, really, Mr. Skouros, now, I must ask you not to entertain such thoughts. Scott is a fine young man and happily married.
So you say, but his wife is not here, is she? He is a man.
You're right,
oh,
your woman is falling
over. Oh, here.
Waiting here for you. You've been out all night with this man. I think you tell me what's going on, eh?
I think you do owe us an explanation, Scott.
Now, fetch. Go on, fetch. Why won't this mutt do anything?
Well, maybe fetching's too difficult for him.
Everything's too difficult for this flea-brained flea-bag.
No, don't call him that. Bouncer is an intelligent dog, aren't you?
Intelligent? Wouldn't know the meaning of the word. I mean, I bought him a rubber bone last Christmas, ate the thing. You watch this. Bouncer, down. Bouncer, off chain, down.
Well, maybe he doesn't feel like getting down.
He's not meant to have feelings. He's supposed to do what he's told.
Are you sure he did everything right the way the video said?
Video's a rip-off. I reckon these dogs already know the tricks.
Well, maybe you should run through it again. I mean, you might be doing something wrong.
Might as well. I've got it for a week. Maybe Toby will have better luck when he gets here.
Mm. You could always ask Mike. Bouncer usually does what he tells him to do.
Oh, does he? Yeah, well, I'll have a go at the video first. Thanks, Jane. Don't like to admit defeat.
I know.
How was it with Mike last night?
We had a nice evening.
Yeah, didn't sit brooding about Des then?
No, I didn't give him a second thought.
Oh, yeah. Been moping around the house like a whipped pup since he gave you the flick.
That's not Des's fault.
Well, he won't have your back, will he? I mean, in my book, that makes him a louse. He's got even less sense than Bouncer.
He's allowed to feel whatever he wants to feel.
Yeah, but anyone who doesn't want a fantastic girl like you, they need the head read.
No, we just dropped the subject. I don't want to talk about Des.
All right. But I don't like the way he's treating you. No way.
It's shameful that my daughter should spend the night with a married man.
Mr. Skouros, nothing...
Shut up!
Dad, I already told you. We were stuck in the middle of nowhere with a flat tire.
Oh, that's a good one. Why don't you get it fixed, huh? You wanted to spend the night alone with my daughter.
Mr. Skouros, we did everything that we could, you know. The service station was closed. Poppy sprained her ankle. Believe me, we didn't stay up because we wanted to.
Ha! Why didn't you ring?
Dad, Scott tried.
You could have phoned this morning, Scott.
Mum, all I got was this engaged signal.
Oh, that'd be right.
Yeah, right.
I tied the phone up calling the hospital.
Exactly, and I thought the best thing to do was just to come straight home.
I was going to call you and Mum from here.
Well, it seems pretty straightforward to me. What do you think, Mr. Skouros?
What do I think? I have been disgraced. My family dishonored.
We didn't do anything wrong.
You didn't do anything wrong. You spent the night together. Oh, your poor mother. And what about Stavros?
What about him?
You think he's going to take this sitting down?
I don't give a damn what Stavros thinks.
Come on, I'm taking you home. You, I hope, will soon join your wife in Queensland.
Who is this Stavros?
Search man.
Oh, some uncle, I suppose.
Well, thank heaven you got home when you did, Scott. Another minute, Mr. Skouros would have been ready to commit mayhem.
I'm just thankful it was all a storm in a teacup. I don't know how I would have told Charlene something had happened to you.
Come on, mate. Just one last shoe. Stop wriggling. Go on, kiss your foot.
And you left yet? You're going to be late for work.
I'm trying to get him ready for the last half hour. He won't cooperate, will you?
Give him to me. I'll dress him and drop him over, Bronnie.
You sure you got time?
I've got heaps of time. I'm here all day long. Got some bloke coming around about the car. I've got stacks of study to do.
In that case, muchas gracias.
All right. Let's show Daddy how easy this is, okay?
How are you feeling about the exam?
Oh, well,
If it's going to be as easy as the last one, it should be a breeze. Here we go. How about that? Come on, let's hit the road, shorty.
See you, matey.
All right.
See you, mate.
Bye. Joe, they're still here?
Yeah, we'll get you.
Hi, baby.
G'day, Joe.
Jane's still hurting about.
Yeah. Yeah, I know.
You just about broke her heart. Do you know that?
Look, I can't help what happened.
Pigs! You let her think you're keen, then you go cold on her. You're a wimp, Clark.
Joe, you got it all wrong, mate. You can't go...
Cuddle this. That's all you're good for.
Okay, I want pastrami on Bavarian rye, sweet pickled tomato. Easy on the Dijon, kosher dill and salt.
Excuse me, double decaf hazelnut latte, medium roasted Colombian beans, 2%.
Sirloin, hoagie, coffee, jack, cheese, lettuce, tomatoes, capers, and Russian dressing. Fresh parmesan and oregano to go.
The new Chrysler Neon, built for the most demanding country in the world.
Sony Handycam Vision, because life isn't a spectator sport.
Contact lenses and solutions from just $9.95 a month. Plus a pair of Aurora sunglasses absolutely free. Specsavers Opticians.
Nestle Cheerios.
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 Multi brain nutrition.
Nestle Cheerios. The goodness of corn, oats, rice, and wheat in four different nutritious whole grain O's. Try them and you'll say.
Multi brain nutrition. It tastes so good.
So good. Good.
Tasted so good.
Such rich, thick, Müller light. Really be a low-fat yogurt. Anything's possible.
Müller light. From Müller, who else? Introducing the remarkable new Sensor XL for women. Feel its specially shaped handle and its soft rubber grip that won't slip when wet.
Feel it.
In front of the blades are soft, flexible microfins to protect your skin while gently lifting stubborn hair. So our spring-mounted twin blades can give you our closest, safest shave ever.
You can feel it.
The new Sensor XL for women.
Feel it.
Do I look like thunder thighs?
You look gorgeous.
Do you think it's a bit too flouncy?
No, it's lovely.
It kind of goes well with my tan, though, doesn't it, the colour?
Yeah, great.
Do you think I look a bit tarty?
Yep, wear it.
No, I'd be yanking it down all the time.
Well, I'll walk behind you, then.
Yeah. Just try one more thing on, OK?
New Soft and Gentle Smooth Solid vanishes instantly, so it doesn't leave a mess behind.
He's happy. He's found a way of getting money off his phone bill.
So are 5 million other people all over the country.
All they did was join BT's Friends and Family Scheme. They get 10% off all calls to the five people who mean most of it. And it's free.
It doesn't cost you a penny. Call 0800 05 55 55 now. Don't you miss out on Friends and Family.
Of course. There are some people who still haven't joined.
The Woolworths £25 million sale. You'll get more than you bargained for.
Have you spoken to Poppy yet?
No, I thought I'd wait until she picks up her car. Give her old man a chance to cool down.
Yeah, sensible. When he turned up at my place this morning, he was like Mount Etna about to erupt.
I'm really sorry about that. I had no idea he'd give you such a hard time.
No harm done. I would have been exactly the same if it had been Charlie. Goodness, you two are safely married and I can forget about all of that.
Yeah. So, how's the big anniversary surprise coming along?
Well, sometimes I don't think it deserves me, but what do you think of that? Wildly extravagant, of course. The less there is of it, the more they charge.
So what's the surprise? A negligee or the price tag?
Oh, no, there's more.
Well, come on. The suspense is killing me, right?
I've booked a night in the bridal suite at Lasseter's.
Very impressive. Not to mention very romantic.
Yeah, but the only problem is I don't know what to buy Harold for a present.
Well, what about a holiday? Well, second honeymoon or something?
No, out of my price range, I'm afraid.
Right. Well, a couple of albums, a ballroom dancing or something. No. Something for scouting, a tent or a woggle or something.
Mm-hmm. A possibility, I suppose.
Yeah. Okay. Here we are.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good.
Ooh, I might have that Pavlova. Yeah. Right,
and what about you, Madge?
Oh, nothing for me, thanks, Harold. My figure won't afford it.
Oh, you're always beautiful to me.
Put you in this romantic mood all of a sudden.
No, nothing special. So that's one Pavlova then, eh?
Thanks.
Big one?
Oh, don't take any notice of him. He's in a silly mood. Just watch it. If you blow my surprise, I'll kill you.
Mum, don't even worry about it. Harold has not got a clue.
Disturb you. I suppose I already have. I bought this for you when I was overseas. I'd like you to have it.
Dears, I really don't think there's any reason for you to give me any presents.
Please take it. Look. It's a scarf.
Dears, I really can't accept it.
We've been friends for so long, I don't want that to change.
Yeah, well, it has. Look, I was really stupid to think we could ever be anything more than just friends. But I can't just forget that it ever happened. It's not going to be so simple to pick up the friendship where it was.
I value our friendship.
Well, then just leave me alone.
I don't want that.
Des, look, maybe I'll be able to handle this a lot better in a little while, but right now, can you just leave me alone?
Sorry.
Remember that dogs enjoy learning. Training your dog could be fun for both of you.
Oh, what a load of garbage. You hear that, Bouncer? Dogs enjoy learning.
Watch now as this dog fetches a ball after only one lesson.
Oh, you hear that? After only one lesson. Why can't you do that? Look, there goes the ball. There goes the dog. Why can't you do that, Bouncer? Here, fetch. Please fetch. Fetch
the
ball, Bouncer!
You never need to raise your voice. All you need to do is be friendly, be firm, and your dog will do anything you tell it to.
Shut up. Your dog will do anything you tell it. Pig's eye. Here, Mangle, card number 484. Yeah, I've got your dog training video and it's a dud. Yeah, my dog sat through it three times, he still doesn't know one flopping trick. What do I want you to do? I want me money back. What do you mean I got Buckley's? What sort of rip-off joint are you running there? Listen, mate, I'm telling you, the video's shonky. Yeah, they're a bunch of circus dogs. Look, I say me instructions to me dog, it just looks at me like I'm a nut. It hasn't even learned to fetch.
Oh, g'day.
G'day.
Thought I might have been the guy coming to buy the car.
You sold it?
Yep. It's coming over later with a bank check.
You study?
Yep. Been at it all day long. I think I'm about as ready for this last exam as I'll ever be. Mm. Hey, I had an interesting story about you getting stuck out in the country with Poppy last night.
Right, Ramsey Street Grapevine.
Yeah. Any truth to the rumour?
Don't even start, Mike. There's nothing going on between Poppy and me, OK?
That's what they all say, Scott. Well, if it isn't the Greek goddess herself. Scott was just telling me about your night of passion.
Nothing like. Hi, Scott.
Hi.
Harry told me you were here.
Oh, you came to get the car. How's your ankle?
Oh, much better.
Well, sit down. Do you want a drink?
Oh, I can only stay a minute.
Well, I'll leave you to it.
I wanted to apologise about Dad getting so heavy.
Oh, no, forget it.
Oh, he's very protective towards me.
Yeah, I noticed. Hey, who's this Stavros guy that he mentioned?
Oh, nobody. He's not important. The main thing is I managed to talk Dad into letting me go on with the articles.
That's great. Well, do you want to go out and celebrate or something?
Better not. I have to go. I'll see you later.
Okay. Well, you take care, all right?
Yeah.
See ya.
Bye.
Nice girl.
Yeah, she's terrific, isn't she? It's a pity she didn't want to go out. Sort of at a loose end.
Well, look, why don't you come around the waterhole with me, have a game of darts? There's someone I want to talk to you about.
My devotion ever true. Let me see, no other message. Day or night.
Mr. Bishop.
Yes, that's it, day or night for my beautiful marriage.
Mr. Bishop, what are you up to?
Oh, I'm sorry, was I speaking out loud?
What are you doing?
Well, actually, I am writing a poem.
Oh, I didn't know you wrote poetry.
Well, it's part of my anniversary surprise for Madge, really.
Lovely.
A little old-fashioned of me, I suppose. Poetry, chocolates.
May I hear the poem?
Oh, no, I don't think so.
Oh, please.
All right. Love is like the passing seasons, never changing but to grow. And we do not need the reasons. Love is all we need to know. Like fragrant flowers or gentle light, my devotion is ever true. No other message day or night. My beautiful Madge, my love is you.
It's lovely.
Oh, well, a little rough around the edges.
Maybe the last line. No. I'm sure Madge will think it's wonderful.
I've got another surprise up my sleeve, too. You know, she thinks I've forgotten.
You wouldn't do that.
Oh, of course not. No, I think if you love someone, you love them forever, don't you?
I think Madge is a very lucky woman. I guess we'll be off. Thanks for the coffee.
My devotion ever true. To my beautiful Madge, my love is you.
Go on, Bouncer. Fetch. You're a hopeless hound, Bouncer. What are you? A hopeless hound.
Joe, you still haven't given up on Bouncer.
Don't ask me why not. I've had it with this dog. Fair dinkum.
Poor Bouncer.
Don't give him your sympathies. I'm the one doing all the work.
Oh, so I should pat you on the head instead, huh? Poor Joe.
Just don't give Bouncer any treats until he learns his lessons. Been shopping.
Oh, Dez gave it to me. He got it overseas.
She's still hanging around.
Daddy wants to be friends.
Oh, yeah.
He insisted that I keep the scarf, although I don't think I'll wear it very often.
What a mongrel. Not you, you fool.
I don't think he meant any harm by it. Anyway, I told him I don't want to see him anymore.
Good on you.
Oh, Joe, what a mess in here.
Yeah, it's my fault. Been hunting one of me thorns. It's gone missing.
Yeah? Well, no one knew it could be anywhere. Do you want me to help you look?
Yeah, Tar.
Maybe we should start in your room. Things usually go in there to die.
You sure that'll do the job? You don't want to miss out on the sale.
That'll be all right. He said he probably wouldn't come over till after work anyway. Hey, listen, about me and Jane, we're still friends, but I don't want to push it, you know.
Is this a guy for the car?
I don't know, I've never seen him before.
Yeah, well, he looks pretty lost, doesn't he?
Hey, mate, can we help you?
Yeah, looking for Scott Robinson.
Well, you found him.
You?
Yeah. What can I do for you?
My name's Stavros Papadopoulos.
Oh, that's right. You're related to Poppy, aren't you?
Yeah. I'm a fiancé.
First I've heard of it.
Well, you know now, so stay away from her.
Hang on a second. Well, if she's engaged to you, then how come she doesn't wear a ring?
Oh, okay. So it isn't official?
Yet.
But it will be. So back off.
Well, not unless she tells me to.
Look, my woman doesn't go out with other blokes.
Listen, mate. All we're doing is working on the same project together.
Not anymore, you're not, mate. I'm warning you. Stay away from her.
I'll keep seeing her as long as we're working together, and after that, if she wants to.
No way.
Stop, look, leave it, will you? You, whack off. It's a bit heavy, man.
You gotta get the message.
Listen, if you want the same hobby, give it a can of
just mate. Drop it, will you?
For you.
Oh, Jim, thank you. But this isn't a special occasion.
It's by way of an apology for the way I carried on about Mother's will.
Oh, it's all behind us. But you can bring me flowers at any time.
Stack of letters here. Most of them for you.
Yes, I've become very popular since that article in the Erinsborough News.
Begging letters.
Plus a lot of offers to sell me things.
Some advantages of being the poor relation.
That's done. No more work until Monday.
You're not enjoying being back at school, Nick?
Oh, it's all right, you know. I hate being broke all the time. The only money I've got's from my study, and there's not much allowance left after I pay board.
Well, perhaps we could reduce that.
No, Helen, I want to carry my weight. I'd just like to have something for me once in a while, that's all.
That was only because she's working late at the hospital and says don't expect her back for dinner.
Oh, no, I've half a sheep roasting in the oven and no one here to eat it.
Where's Todd?
Over at Gary's.
Oh, well, lamb sandwiches for a week.
Oh, but you know how much Paul enjoys your roasts. Why not invite him and Gail to join us?
Oh, that's a good idea.
Can I go and play with Toby?
Is he back?
Joe has him for the weekend.
May I please go and play with Toby?
All right, darling, but put on a jumper. It's starting to get chilly out there.
Yeah. Thanks, Ray.
Hi. Come on in.
Is your dad home?
Yeah.
Well, I think we should give it a miss. Why don't you come out?
Sure, if you like.
Stavros came looking for me this afternoon.
Should have warned you. Dad told him about last night. He wasn't very happy.
Well, we had a little bit of a discussion, actually. I punched him.
Oh, Scott.
He's your fiancé, isn't he? Poppy, why didn't you tell me?
Stavros is not my fiancé.
Well, that's not what he's saying.
Better explain. My dad and Stavros' father came to Australia together. They were business partners. Stavros and I grew up running in and out of each other's houses. Our parents always expected we'd get married.
Well, Stavros does too.
Yeah, but I don't. I'm fond of him. He's a nice guy when you know him properly. There's no way I'd marry him.
Hmm. Yeah, maybe we should drop this project for a while.
Why?
Well, it's your dad, Stavros. You know, I don't want you getting in strife.
You leave that to me. I can handle them.
You sure?
Yep. Back to work tomorrow, right?
Right.
Skye, look, you're going to have to do a lot better than this before I take you to any five-star restaurants. Look at you.
Kerry, I want to ask your opinion on something.
Yeah?
It took me a long time to track this down. It is a particularly fine aftershave.
Oh, gee, it's, powerful.
Yes, well, I'm going to wear it on our anniversary night. Women are supposed to find it irresistible, you know.
Well, Madge is going to be quite overwhelmed.
Oh, I do hope so. Well, I think a gesture like this should be on an anniversary night, don't you?
Here you go, Kerry. Oh, thanks, Madge.
What's that hole?
What?
There's a very peculiar smell in here, isn't it?
Well, it's a, maybe
it's probably my perfume. I picked it up when I was travelling in Asia.
Oh, sorry.
Well, I guess it's not quite irresistible after all.
Back to the drawing board, eh?
Well, you can always ask for your money back, you know.
No. Oh, Miss Robinson, do come in.
I've come to collect the coffee shop keys for the morning.
Oh.
Whatever is that dreadful stench?
Aftershave.
A Christmas present, was it?
No, are you sure you don't want me to come in the morning?
Well, the coffee shop is hardly crowded of a Saturday. I can manage perfectly well on my own.
Oh, well, I suppose so. You'll be wanting a float for the till.
Isn't it time that child was feeding herself? She's trying.
Here we are, all pre-checked.
Yes, I should think so. Well, I'll drop these back along with the keys on Sunday. Good night.
Stench indeed.
What's this? It's magic.
Oh, no such thing as magic, mate.
It's so. I've got instructions and everything. I take these three empty papers, place them over the glasses. Now, which one has the 20 cents underneath it?
That's easy, mate. The middle one.
Katie?
Oh, this one?
This one?
Excellent.
That's good, mate. Where is it?
I don't know.
Oh, dear. There it is!
Oh, it's a con. That'll be the Wizard of Oz.
G'day, Jim.
Hi, Joe. Is Katie here?
Yeah, come in.
Hello, Toby. It's dinner time, young lady.
Wait a minute, Uncle Jim. You've got to see this. Toby knows magic.
Oh, does he?
Yes.
Show him.
Okay. This one's eights. I need your watch, Katie.
All right.
I take this watch and place it into the bag.
Oh, I hope you know what you're doing, sport.
Tomorrow.
Steady on. Are you sure about this, Toby? That's a real watch, not a toy.
Don't worry. I just open the bag. So,
Toby, you idiot! It's my watch.
Oh, no worries. Mangle the magician will now work his magic. Aya Kazam, Aya Shazam, Timbuktu, good as new.
My watch, it's okay. Excellent.
Oh, good one, mate.
Can you teach me, then I could be assistant.
Okay.
That's very impressive, Toby, very impressive. But look, when you're teaching Katie, use someone else's watch, would you? Come on, darling. You can see Toby tomorrow. Bye-bye.
Straight after breakfast, all right?
See ya.
See you later. Hey, geez, they're good tricks, mate. How'd you do them?
Sorry, Dad. It's a secret.
Watch out, there's a hut.
Oh, looks wonderful. Thanks, Nick.
Okay.
As soon as Dad gets back with Katie and Gran gets off the phone, we'll be able to drink to your success with the gift shop, eh?
When does it open?
Monday. A bit nervous.
What for? You running it couldn't be anything but huge. Eh?
That killer in can be a bit of a problem.
What's she done this time?
I've just been on the phone to her about accepting some of my inheritance to repay her back for the figurine.
And she didn't want to accept.
Oh, she agreed, all right. She would have thought I was trying to borrow money from her rather than give it to her.
Oh, I wish some had come my way.
Hey, hang on. I thought Gran was organising something for your grandmother's grave.
Yeah, well, she is. I didn't mean that
Nick's
I was...
Nick's finding it a bit difficult now that he's back at school and not much money's coming in.
Any chance of a big commission from Lassiter's? I could do some paintings for the rooms and...
Sorry, Nick, but non-essentials are pretty well out of the question right now.
Yeah, I could say that.
Last one, Dad?
Yeah. Hey, thanks, mate.
Has everybody told you what they like from Legacy yet, Helen?
Yes, everybody but Paul.
So, have you made up your mind yet?
Yes, I've thought about it very carefully. I wanted to use this opportunity for the most important thing I could think of. And what would give me the greatest happiness is a child of our own. So, Gran, if you'd like to put some money into a bank account that we could use solely for the IVF program, I think that'd be the greatest gift of all.
Good morning, Mr. Bishop.
Oh, good morning, Miss Robinson. Well, you're making an early start this morning.
Well, no point in wasting half the morning.
Quiet. You haven't seen a morning paper, have you? Mine hasn't arrived again.
Mine neither. I assumed it was merely sloppy service.
Oh, dear, this is getting out of hand. The newspaper's gone missing again.
Oh, hold on, get yourself in a knot about it. Try to relax. It's Saturday. Be grateful you're not working for a change. Come on.
Oh, you're right, I suppose. But it is infuriating.
Dad, would you like me to give you a hand at the coffee shop next week?
Oh, yes, thank you, Kerry. Yes, that would ease the load.
Good.
Well, it's time to wake up Skye. She'll be wanting a breakfast.
I'll come with you.
More toast?
No, thanks. I think I'd better get started.
You working today?
No, I'm just typing up some of the notes from the interview we did yesterday. Poppy's coming around a bit late.
Look, just hang on a minute, Scott. I need your advice on something.
Oh, yeah?
It's Harold's anniversary present. I need a male opinion. Now, what do you think?
And took my advice, eh? Yeah, it's fantastic. I think he'll love it.
Yeah, not that I think he even knows it's our anniversary.
Have you reminded him?
I've dropped a few hints.
Well, maybe you're being a little too subtle. Harold's got a very one-track mind. You should try the direct approach.
Like a sledgehammer, you mean?
Yeah.
Maybe you're right. Perhaps I need to get a bit more obvious.
Can't you control your son, Mr. Mangle? He's teaching Katie bad habits.
He's not annoying anyone.
There's such a thing as manners, you know. What is the use? Look, if there's nothing else I can get you, I'd like to close up. I have my own shopping to do, you know.
And what are you?
$4, please. Mm-hmm.
Thanks, Mr. Mangle. That was great.
Oh, yours good, was it?
Yep, not bad. That's a new $10, isn't it?
Give that back, please. You're not supposed to touch the takings. Now I have lost count.
Toby could help you count it again. He's really good with money. He can make it disappear.
Katie, will you please not interrupt? I don't want to lose count again.
Sorry. Hey, have you seen Toby's new vanishing coin trick?
No, I have not.
You'll like this, Miss Robinson. I'll need a dollar coin.
Now, what are you doing? I told you not to touch it.
I only need a minute.
Will you give it back? Now leave the money alone.
Keep your shirt on.
It is not play money, Mr. Mangle.
He's not playing. He's demonstrating one of his skills.
There is no skill in playing silly tricks. Now, if the three of you will excuse me.
What do you think about the Robinson Corporation in red lettering?
What are you doing?
Working out our new letterheads.
Your new letterheads, you mean? Don't you think the Robinson Corporation is a little egotistical?
No. What'd you think I was going to call it?
Well, something less personal.
No way. I've worked a long time for this. Yeah, what do you reckon about in gold, then?
You are impossible. What do you think of this?
What, to use, or are you asking me as a potential customer?
No, for the gift shop. You think we should stock it?
No, I think we should bin it.
Yep, I feel the same. We should definitely be going more upmarket, but maybe we should concentrate on something that the businessman might take home to his wife.
All right, how about an empty laundry bag to take home his dirty shirts in?
That is a terrible suggestion and very sexist.
Yes, but true. It's better than a tea towel anyway.
Will you ever bring me home something like that and I'd strangle you with it?
I'd like to see it try. Listen, what about T-shirts? They always sell well, don't they?
I suppose I'd trust you to buy me a T-shirt.
Yeah.
It's a great idea.
That's what I'm here for.
I don't know, it's something I've just thought of. And it could be the answer to more than one problem.
Hi, Hilary. How are you? Quite exhausted since you asked. Busy this morning. Not more so than usual. But running the coffee shop's quite a responsibility, and I have my own shopping to get done.
Well, I'm sure Dad's very grateful.
So you got some bird seed. How are those birds going that I gave you?
Settling in all right?
Very well.
Not entirely what I would have chosen, but still.
Hey, Kerry.
Hi.
Hi, Skye. How's my littlest mate then, eh?
Quite underwhelmed, I should think.
We're going to go for a walk in the park. Do you want to come?
Oh, no, thanks. I've just been down there with this lot. We've got to take Katie home anyway.
Toby's got some new magic tricks to show Uncle Jim.
Well, come on then, little Liz. Let's go, eh? Come on.
Bye.
See you later. Take the fruit back.
That boy knows quite enough tricks already. He totally distracted me while I was cashing up.
I was speaking to Dad earlier and I'm going to come and help out in the coffee shop. Skye will enjoy being with other kids at crèche.
Oh, well, there's no substitute for a mother's care. Still, your help will be welcome.
Well, it's about time I did something to earn my keep. Well, we'll be off for our walk. I'll see you sometime next week in the coffee shop.
Bye-bye, Kerry.
Bye.
Bye, Skye. No, not the takings.
Mumbo jumbo, make it right. Now it's here.
Oh! Whoa! Well done.
Do another one.
Do
smashing a watch.
That sounds a bit expensive.
Ah, it's perfectly safe, Helen. Here, show me how to do that one.
Oh. Here's my watch.
This must be good.
Ah, it's a piece of cake. I'll work this one out the first time I saw it. Here, I'll show you.
Dad!
No probs, mate. Got this one sussed.
Dad, that's Mr. Robinson's watch.
Yeah, so?
He didn't make the switch.
Oh. You mean that really is my watch? Oh, wonderful. That was a gift from Bear for my birthday.
Oh, sorry, mate. I can fix the watch.
Hillary.
Is that Mangle person here?
Yes, he is. Won't you come in?
The money bag from the coffee shop. Where is it?
Eh?
I had it with me just now and it's vanished. Is this one of your silly tricks?
You hold your horses.
Well, where is it?
I don't know. I haven't got it.
Yeah, you heard the kid.
Toby wouldn't take your money bag, not even for a joke. You made a mistake.
Well, if that's the case, what's happened to the money? I know I had it with me when I put my shopping down, then it was just gone. Oh, what am I going to tell Mr. Bishop? A whole morning's takings.
I'm sure it will turn up.
Yes, but where?
Thanks, mate. Sticking up for Toby like that?
That's all right. I'll be back by buying me a new watch.
Anyone seen the salt?
Oh, it's over there.
I know too much isn't good for one, but I do like some salt on my tomato sandwiches.
Don't worry, Mr. Bishop, a little salt won't hurt you.
It's the first currency, you know. The ancients used to use it instead of money.
That gives me an idea.
What's that?
Well, we've got this done. We should have dinner at Uncle Larry's restaurant.
I don't have to think twice about that.
Good. Now, about Mrs. Galanos and her cousin.
No, you didn't want anything to eat, did you, Madge?
No, nothing.
Oh, dear, it is good to relax.
Anything you need?
No, no. Fine, thank you.
You don't need to go and buy anything at the shops?
No. No. Yeah, that's what I like about the weekends. Nothing to do but to lie back and relax, eh?
Sunday tomorrow.
Yes, all day.
Got any plans?
No. Church, afternoon snooze, good chance to recharge the old batteries, eh?
Yeah, can't have you straining the dynamo, can we?
Sorry?
Oh, nothing, Harold. It doesn't matter.
What's this idea you rang about? It's something I'd like to stock in the gift shop, and I need your help.
Sure, what is it?
Well, most of our business is from tourists and businessmen taking souvenirs home. Something with an Australian motive on them.
Like printed T-shirts, for example.
And I thought, with your artistic talents, you might like to design them for us.
And print them as well. Take the whole thing off our hands. A few bucks in it for you. You're going to be your own boss. What do you reckon?
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, great. When do we start?
The sooner the better. I can supply you with 100 plain T-shirts to get you started, but the printing equipment, you're going to have to chase up yourself.
Oh, that's no worries. I know someone who's got all that stuff. I could borrow it off him.
Okay. Listen, I'll leave you guys to it. I'll get on your favour and discuss some business with Harold, okay? See ya.
It's a wonderful opportunity for you, Nick.
Oh, I don't know what to say except...
Fantastic!
Let's get stuck into it.
Harold?
Yes, Madge?
I was thinking, why don't we go off by ourselves tomorrow? Drive, maybe some dinner, just the two of us.
Oh, no, I don't think so. No, I've been working very hard lately. I need my rest. Perhaps a quiet night, eh?
Quiet night? But, Harold, all you seem to think about lately is sleep and work. I mean, you've got no consideration for my feelings. Never mind that I might like to go somewhere.
Don't be unreasonable, man.
Well, I've had enough. If you haven't got better things to do with your time, I certainly have.
Yeah, well, I think that's an extremely selfish attitude.
Of all the boring, fuddy-duddy stick-in-the-mud, Harold Bishop, you are the limit.
And of all the quarrelsome, pig-headed women
it,
I have...
Harold, don't you say another word. Just forget I mentioned it.
With pleasure.
What's going on in there?
Oh, that man. He doesn't deserve an anniversary surprise. I'm going to call the whole thing off.
What's wrong?
If he can't remember our anniversary, then he can just forget it. Hello, Prue. It's Madge. I'd like to cancel a booking.
Cancel it.
What?
Cancel it. The whole thing is off. It's off.
Harold, you've got to be joking.
That's right. In the name of Smith. Cancel it.
Mum,
Are you sure about this?
Positive.
My decision is final, Paul. Goodbye. Don't say a word.
Huh? I wouldn't waste my breath. Go.
Looks pretty good, Nick. But how does it work?
That's pretty simple, really. You get these dies, you squeeze them under the screen, then squeeze it over and bingo. Instant pattern.
Can we start now?
Well, not in here. It's a bit too messy. But Jim says I can set up shop in the garage.
Has Will got those T-shirts yet?
Yeah, he scored 100 plain ones from a mate.
100? That's going to take us ages.
No, it won't. Not once we get the design done. We'll breeze through it.
Will you make a lot of money?
Enough to buy a new skateboard, I reckon. And mine's had it. But the really great part is I get to do my own design.
What's it going to be?
Well, Gail made a few suggestions. She wants an Australian theme that the tourists will go for.
Sounds pretty good.
Mm. Would you want to give me a hand?
Oh, yeah, that'd be great. Thanks.
Me too?
Oh, you're a bit too young, Katie.
Yeah, Katie, you're just getting in the way.
I wouldn't talk to you.
Maybe next time around, all right?
I should have gone to the movies with Glenn and the
others. Do you want me to put this stuff in the garage?
Yeah, well, you do that and I'll start working on the pattern. You know, I really appreciate this chance, Todd, and I want to come up with a surefire winner.
Have you told Harold the money's gone missing?
Not yet. I said I'd bring the takings over in the morning. I didn't like evading the issue, but maybe there's the possibility I made a mistake. It's here somewhere.
Where?
I don't know, Sharon. Start looking.
I thought you said you were sure you'd taken the money home.
Yes, I was, but now I'm hoping for a miracle and that it'll turn up here somewhere.
Oh, well, maybe we're overlooking something. Let's go over it again.
Been over and over it, and I simply haven't the faintest idea how it disappeared. If I don't find it, I'll have to explain the whole thing to Mr. Bishop and Mr. Clark. I only hope they don't blame me.
Well, the takings were your responsibility, weren't they?
I said I would take the money home out of the goodness of my heart. I refuse to be held responsible.
These are top quality. If Nick comes up with a good motive, I reckon we're on a winner.
Thanks, so.
Did you take the rest over to him?
Hmm? No, they're still in the boot of the car. Don't panic, I'll drop them in on the way to work tomorrow.
Thought you guys were throwing a batch to launch the Robinson Corporation.
We are, but we've still got a few urgent things to do at the office first.
Robinson Corporation, it's got a nice little ring to it, hasn't it?
Well, it's not bad. But let's face it, it doesn't sound as classy as something like Ramsey.
Hey, H, watch it.
Is that why you're finding it so hard to get a flat? Because you can't bear to move out of Ramsey Street?
Well, we can't find a decent flat in Erinsborough, let alone Ramsey Street. You wouldn't believe some of the dives the agents have shown me.
Listen, why don't you put an ad in the Erinsborough News?
Yeah.
Well, I thought of that. The trouble is, Bonnie's never home to take any of the calls. She's either busy mining Jamie or tied up with a tick. It's getting to the point where I have to make an appointment to see her these days.
You're not begrudging her going back to school, are you, Henry?
Oh, okay, of course not. But it is making things pretty rugged, so... Can we have a bit longer?
Yeah, sure. As long as you keep looking, okay?
I plan to spend most of tomorrow doing just that. Can I get you something else?
No, thanks, Henry.
All right.
Skye's having a good sleep in?
Hmm. So, Scott. Would you pass the sugar, please, Kerry? Thank you.
Thought I might give the coffee shop a good, thorough cleaning today. Would you care to give me a hand, Kerry?
Dad, it's Sunday.
Yes, I am aware of that, but I thought we can go in after church.
I thought you'd be looking for excuses to stay around the house all day today.
Why on earth would I want to do that?
Well, what about Skye?
I'll look after Skye. It'll be nice to have the place to ourselves for a change. Don't get up, anybody. I'll answer it.
For heaven's sake, Dad. It's your anniversary. You've got to kiss and make up.
As far as I'm concerned, this argument is Madge's fault. And until she sees fit to apologise to me that I have no intention of making up, as you put it, and if she doesn't want to remember our anniversary, then why should I? Hmm?
Oh, dear. I would have thought you'd have finished breakfast by now.
It is Sunday.
Quite all right, Miss Robinson. Another morning, another breakfast, nothing special.
Yes, well, I'm afraid my news is not going to do a lot for your appetite.
Oh, dear, that sounds ominous.
It's about the takings from the coffee shop. I'm afraid they've disappeared.
They've what?
Look, I don't know what happened. One moment they were there on the ground with my other things, the next they'd vanished.
But they can't have just disappeared. Somebody must have stolen them.
Yes, well, that's what I thought. But now I'm quite satisfied it wasn't anyone who was with me. Look, I just don't know what to think.
Why on earth didn't you tell me this last night?
Dad, take it easy.
Somebody steals our hard-earned takings and you tell me to take it easy. There is a criminal at large and justice must be done.
Mr. Bishop, there is no point in losing your temper with me. It wasn't my fault.
Well, I suppose the police can soon sort this out.
There's no need to call them in just yet, Dad. I mean, there's probably a very simple explanation. The money must be around somewhere.
Well, it had better turn up soon. This is all I needed today.
Hey, Houdini. Ain't you supposed to be giving me a hand?
Gardening's boring.
Yeah, a lot of things are, mate, but they've got to be done.
But nobody makes famous magicians do gardening.
Oh, famous, are we?
Yep.
Well, look, you're so crash hot at magic. Here, I go and wave this and make those weeds disappear. Hey, come back here with that. Bouncer, come back here with my glove.
Bouncer,
that's the way.
Out.
Thank you. I don't believe this.
What?
Take a look at this.
Told you he was a smart dog.
Think I might have overtrained him a bit, eh? And told him to go and get my papers. Not everybody else's. Well, have a look at that. Voila. Mystery solved. You got your money back. End of story.
Well, I am certainly glad to learn that there isn't a thief at large, eh?
Oh, there is, I think. Just his bark's worse than his bite, eh?
Well, I'm very relieved to hear it, but I trust that dog will be severely punished.
Just leave him to me. He just needs a bit of rehabilitation. But what about you?
What do you mean, what about me?
You were pretty quick to point the finger. I reckon you owe young Toby an apology.
So do I.
Given the circumstances, I think my suspicions were perfectly natural. However, now we know who the real culprit is, I don't see any point in continuing this discussion. I have far better things to do.
Mrs. Mangle would be horrified to learn that a precious bouncer had turned into some sort of a kennel hoarder, eh?
I'm afraid it's much more serious than that, Mr. Bishop. That dog is obviously a kleptomaniac. Well, how do we know he won't continue taking things? I'm certainly not prepared to put up with it. And I doubt if anyone else in Ramsey Street would either.
Well, I'll keep him off the street until I untrain him.
Well, see that you do.
What a... battle axe.
Hey! Hey! You're not chucking those out, are you?
Well, they're stale. But if you want them...
They look pretty good to me. I haven't eaten for 2 days.
Oh, that's terrible here. I think it's awful that so much waste goes on when so many people aren't getting enough to eat.
A tragedy, I call it.
So do I. Look, if you'd like to come back at lunchtime, I could give you some decent food.
Oh, that's... very good of you, miss. I really appreciate it. I suppose it'd be too much to ask if I could bring a mate. Oh, he's had a real rough time lately.
Of course you can. Oh,
thanks a lot. I think you're a truly good-hearted lady.
See you at lunch.
Doing your favourite son a teeny weeny little favour?
What a straight answer.
What's that mean?
No.
Oh, come on! Just an itty bitsy little repair job!
Why don't you ask Bronwyn?
I would if I ever got to see her.
I'm sorry, Henry, not today. I've got a million things to do around the house. I'm looking after Skye, and anyway, I hate the whole rotten world.
Oh, pardon me for breathing. I'm out of here.
Oh, no, I'm sorry. It's not you.
Well, what's the problem?
Harold.
Oh, what's King of the Brownies been up to this time?
Forgotten our anniversary.
What? Casanova himself? I don't believe it.
It's true. I've dropped enough hints to sink the Queen Mary. And what have I got? Zilch.
Well, maybe you've been too subtle.
Subtle? I've done everything but parade around in my wedding dress.
It's not like him, is it?
I don't know. Maybe it's just the same old story. I mean, they're lovely and sensitive and kind, and they waltz you up the aisle. Your father was the same. After that, he just took me for granted. He never remembered a damn thing. I really thought with Harold it'd be different. First anniversary, so special.
No, bookings are going well. We're almost full up.
Oh, that reminds me. I've got a cancellation to put through. How many bookings are there in the name of Jones?
About as many as we have for Smith. That's the other favourite name for unmarried couples.
I didn't think people worried about that anymore.
Well, not everyone's as liberated as us, darling.
Oh, we're liberated now, are we? I thought we were just respectable married couple.
Actually, I had somebody in that category book a suite the other day in the name of Smith.
Yeah, who?
Someone we both know well.
Yeah,
it's strictly confidential.
Oh, Gail, of course it is. Who?
Madge. Only she must have changed her mind because all of a sudden she cancelled.
Yeah, the booking that I'm cancelling is in the name of Jones, as in Bishop. Harold?
Harold?
Yeah.
Well, they must have both had the bright idea of surprising each other, and then for some reason or other they've both decided to cancel.
Curiouser and curiouser, said Alice.
Well, I hope they haven't had a misunderstanding or anything.
Sounds a bit like it, doesn't it?
Are you thinking what I'm thinking?
Right with you, Mrs. Robinson.
Now, don't you forget those crisper drawers, will you?
I won't forget that.
Well, we must keep this place spotless, Kerry. The kitchen is just like an operating theatre. Sterility is all important.
I'll try to remember that.
What have we got here?
Oh, I'm just making a bit of vegetable stew for lunch.
Good. Well, I'll finish the floors, then I'll join you, eh?
Okay.
Am I too early?
No, coming right up now.
She's got some tucker for us.
I nearly fainted when Clarence turned up with three mates instead of one. Hi, Dave.
Well, you know what a tightwad Harold is. If he gets wind of it, you'll be out in your ear in 5 seconds flat.
Well, he doesn't pay me to work at the coffee shop, so why shouldn't I hand out a few free meals to people who really need them?
You mean he's got you working there for nothing?
Well, I'll get my meals.
Oh, even so.
Oh, I don't know. I mean, sort of a trade-off, I guess. I mean, he's putting a roof over my head.
I thought you said you're paying rent.
Only what I can afford. The single-parent benefit isn't exactly a fortune, you know.
Yeah, well, that's what I mean. He should be happy to help out. Sounds like your living with the old man isn't the best arrangement.
It's not. We've been having a few arguments about how I'm bringing up Skye. Oh, I'm sorry, Joe. I didn't mean to come over here and whinge. But it does help to talk to someone about it.
Hey, that's what friends are for, mate. Look, how about we put the kettle on, have a cup of tea? We haven't had a good yarn for ages.
You're on. I'll do it.
What's up?
Oh, just thinking, mate. Kerry's having it tough at the Bishop's. Well, we've got plenty of space here, right? What would you think if she moved in here?
Well, do you think Jane would mind?
Oh, probably the company cheer up. All right, spill the beans. What's worrying you?
Well, I was sort of hoping you and Mum might get back together after a while.
Oh, mate. I don't think there's much chance of that. Not the way I feel about Kerry.
You're the boss.
Hey, that's not how we operate. You got to feel good about it too.
Well, if that's what you want, I guess it's okay with me.
Ah, thanks, sport. You were right, you know that?
I bet Skye cries all the time.
Oh, you did your fair share when you're little. We'll jump that hurdle when we come to it.
Can I go over to Katie's?
Sure, go for it.
Night tea for you, Toby.
No, thanks.
Kettle won't be long.
There's no hurry. Hey, me and Toby just had a bit of a powwow.
Oh, yeah? What about?
Well, we were thinking that if it'd make it easier for you, how about you and Skye moving here?
Oh, Joe, I didn't mean to come and drop all my problems into your lap.
You haven't.
Look, I do appreciate the offer. Can't tell you how much. But I'm not sure if I'm ready for that yet.
Oh, I just thought it'd help out, you know.
I know. And I'm terribly grateful. But I think I should try and stick it out with Madge and Harold just for a bit longer.
Sure. Yeah. It's no big deal. Just thought I had.
Woohoo!
We made it. Got the last one finished right on time.
Always were a pretty good team, weren't we?
Yeah. Hey, what about me? I wasn't exactly standing around doing nothing.
Well, you both did a fantastic job. Oh, I can't wait to show Paul and go.
Well, why don't we take them straight over now?
No, we ought to clean this up first. That was part of the deal when Jim said we could work here, right?
Todd and I will do that. I think you should put one on and model it for them, just like the pros do.
Yeah?
Yeah.
She'll go ape over that design.
That came out fantastic, didn't it?
Sure did. Now put it on. When Gail sees that, she's going to want another 100, I reckon.
You think so?
Couldn't be surer. I think we're on a really big thing here.
Todd, would you get those dollar signs out of your eyes and clean up?
Oh, hi, Vince.
Oh, hello. Henry said you were up to your necks in preparations for the company party. Yeah, well, we are.
Yeah, but you see, something came up at the office, and quite frankly, it's got us a little bit puzzled.
Not something I've done at work, I hope.
No. The confusion actually begins with Harold.
Well, now, if this is business, perhaps you'd prefer to discuss it privately.
Oh, well, it is and it isn't.
You've lost me.
Well, it's to do with the hotel room that you booked, Harold.
I told you that was to be kept strictly confidential.
Yes, I know, but when Paul discovered that Madge had booked the bridal suite through me, we naturally wondered what was going on.
Mm. So we thought we'd better come over and clarify things with you before we put the cancellations through.
Oh, Harold, I thought you'd forgotten.
Well, I thought you were too grouchy to care.
It's all I've been thinking about.
We should have known better, eh?
Oh, I've been dying to give you this all day.
Oh, I've got something for you too.
Well, maybe we should...
No, we've got to sort this out.
Happy anniversary, darling.
And to you too, treasure.
Oh, Harold, I do hope you haven't given me a sensible present. You know I hate practical gifts. Oh, Harold, my favourite weakness. They're gorgeous.
Oh. Madge, did you know how much I wanted one of these? Oh, look! Oh, it'll be such a boon on the camping trips with the scouts.
Oh.
Madge?
Hmm?
I did buy you a car too, but... Well, I thought on our first anniversary... Well, it merited something special, so...
You've written me a poem. Isn't that the most romantic thing you've ever heard of? Love is like the passing season, never changing but to grow. And we do not need the reasons. Love is all we need.
Come on. Like fragrant flowers or gentle light, my devotion is ever true. No other message day or night. My beautiful Madge, my love is you.
Oh, wow, that's beautiful.
Well, all we have to do now is sort out the little matter of which suite to cancel.
What's it to be, the Arcadia or the Bridal?
Well, Mrs. B, your place or mine?
Place it over the glass. Alibaba. Gee, if I really seem to have messed up that trick, your $2 has really disappeared.
Yes, and I know when I'm being conned, my friend.
But it was a good trick.
Oh, yes, but I think once is enough. I can't afford to lose another $2.
Anyone home?
Yeah, guys, we're in here. Where's Gail? She and Paul went over to the office. They should be back in a tick. What's so urgent?
I want to show them my design for the T-shirts. What do you reckon?
Yeah, we've finished the whole run.
Isn't it fantastic?
Well, it's great. You'll be a real girl with the tourists.
Yeah. What's the matter, Katie? Don't you like it?
Yeah, sure, but why have you written dessert on it when you haven't even got any food?
It doesn't say dessert, it says desert.
You should have checked your spelling. Desert only has one S.
What? No, Toby, you're just...
You should have let me help. I would have got it right. I'm really good at spelling.
Me too.
I don't believe this. Why didn't one of you say something?
Well, I would have if I'd realised. What are we going to do now?
I lose my job, my big chance. Just messed up 100 T-shirts.
I hate to say this, mate, but I think you got trouble.
Yeah, tell me about it.
How could we make such a stupid mistake?
I don't know.
I don't know.
fumes from the dye.
Look, we can fix it.
No, we can't, Sharon. These t-shirts are worth $5 a pop. That's, what, $500 down the drain.
$500? Are you serious?
We'll get some more blanks. Do a reprint. We'll all help.
Have you got that sort of dough? I haven't.
Oh, hang on. Look, no panic, no despair. Let's just talk it through. There's always an answer.
Hey, I know. Put a picture of an apple pie in.
Oh, yeah, brilliant. Pinhead and apple pie.
Your lip list didn't make the word make sense.
Well, why can't we just blank the word out and reprint over the top of it?
It doesn't work that way. I think Todd's got a point there. Yes, you could add to the print. Look, what if you whacked a black snake in the middle there or a winding river, to, you know, something to cover up that extra...
Henry, if I change anything, the picture will look rotten. I mean, things are bad enough without people saying my work stinks.
It was an honest mistake, Nick. Now, if you explain it to Gail...
Gail expects 100 printed T-shirts tomorrow morning at Lassiter's. She's a professional and should expect a professional job from me. That means I've blown any chance I had at making money out of the gift shop.
Just dump them over there, Kevin. If you go back, the chef's got some more savories. If you can pick those up too. Oh, nice touch.
Yeah, well, everything else has been catered for, and I've got a bit of a thing about flowers.
Oh, I've invited a couple of travel agents down this afternoon too for the party.
Paul, you didn't. Today's for family, friends and staff. You know that.
Family, yeah, and I resisted the temptation. Mind you, we are going to have to do the 5 o'clock business thing next week, you realise?
Yeah, well, that's next week.
Oh, I've sent some champagne up to the bridal suite for Madge and Harold too. Shame they can't join us, really. But I think it's better to be alone on your first wedding anniversary, isn't it?
You know, I knew there was a romantic lurking under that bar humbug exterior.
I've actually booked the same suite for us when I was coming around here.
Well, you're pretty sure of yourself, aren't you?
Betcha.
Sorry. Didn't know you were so busy.
Pretty lousy timing, Des.
Well, I don't know. I saw the whole thing.
Right.
Listen, I thought I'd better tell you I won't be able to make it this afternoon.
Oh, that's a shame.
I am pretty disappointed, mate. Well, the Robinson Corporation wouldn't exist at all if you hadn't backed us.
Can't be helped, I'm sorry.
Well, is there something wrong? Anything we can do?
No, it's just one of those things. I hope it goes well. See you later.
Yeah, right, mate. Bit of a downer?
I hope Jamie's not sick or something.
No, he would have told us.
He didn't tell us anything.
No, he didn't really. He must have something on his mind.
Hi.
A little overdressed, don't you think?
Ha-ha, very funny. Come in.
No, I don't think I've ever known a girl who's been ready on time.
It's just you guys, isn't it? A pair of jeans, a splash of aftershave.
Splash and a half, thanks.
Whatever.
I noticed there's no ute in the driveways. Joe taking Toby out somewhere, is he?
Yeah. He has to go back to his mum's tonight, so Joe's taking him to the speedway. Little monster is doing his Wayne Gardner impersonations all through breakfast.
You know, you've just made my day.
What?
Well, I never thought I'd ever see you smile again.
Well, I haven't had much reason to, have I?
No, I guess not.
You know, I wake up every morning and I tell myself there's no point in moping about Des. One day I'll get over him.
Water under the bridge, eh?
No, not romantic enough. About snow of yesteryear.
Well, thanks for telling me how you got through it. I could have used that advice when things didn't work out so well for us.
It seems like a million years ago.
Yeah, not for me.
It's weird when you fall in love. When everything's so great, it feels like you couldn't possibly hurt anyone or hurt yourself. Everything's so straightforward. Is that growing up, Mike? Realising there's no point in looking back?
Well, some people say love's stronger the second time round, huh? Jane.
Mike, don't. Look, I wouldn't have got through this whole mess with Des without you. You're the best friend I've got. I don't want to mess up that friendship by playing games with memories.
Todd, well, these are great.
But you don't have to stuff yourself.
Yeah, but I'm starving.
After the lunch you put away.
Oh, that was hours ago. Anyway, the food's here to be eaten, isn't it?
Eaten, not pigged out.
Yeah, all right.
Well, this wouldn't have been Katie's scene. She's much happier at the Speedway with the Rev Heads.
Rev Heads?
Yes. With Katie, Todd and Nick around, I'm adding to my vocabulary all the time.
Well, as long as you take some cake home, then Katie won't feel she's missed out.
Oh, Joe led me to believe that they're going on a fast food crawl on the way home, so I think I'd be better off with some Alka-Seltzer.
Ladies, gentlemen, and family.
Oh, speech.
Speech.
A man works hard setting up a business, raising a family. You're proud of what you do. You cover your mistakes. But you're even prouder when your son achieves the sort of thing that we're here to celebrate today.
He's all on his own, did he, Jim?
Hey, I'm buttering him up deliberately, Gail. You see, every father has this private nightmare. When your son's the head of this big corporation and you wake up one day to discover that the cheeky so-and-so has taken over your business. So this is by way of graft. Congratulations, Paul, and take it easy on your old man, would you? Robinson Corporation.
Sorry, we're late.
This is your fault. I bet you he's been working on those t-shirts all the time.
Why don't we?
Oh, well.
Nick, it's not that urgent. You weren't supposed to miss out on the party. And I don't want your schoolwork to suffer either. If you need more time, it's no problem.
Well, the t-shirts are printed, Gail.
Oh, great.
You should give him a bonus.
Yeah, well, I will.
But I misspelled a word. They're all spoiled. Useless.
Silly spelling mistake. Schools have a lot to answer for.
That's a sign of hardening of the arteries, Helen. I mean, Nick makes a simple mistake and you blame the education system.
Oh, if every mistake cost $500, there'd be a lot of kids getting 10 out of 10.
Well, are you suggesting teachers should institute a fine system?
Both barrels of the shotgun for Nick, isn't it? Well, owing the money and losing the work.
Oh, Gail won't make him pay the money back, surely.
Perhaps she should. I mean, isn't taking responsibility for mistakes part of the deal?
Oh, I've got it. Hello, Robinson residence. Yes, speaking. Just a minute. Beverly, could you pass me that notebook? The solicitors from Hong Kong. They want my account number and I wrote it down there earlier.
There you go.
Thank you. Are you there? Good. It's 839-12256789. 789, yes, that's right. Are you sure? Well, no. Thank you. Thank you, goodbye. Well, seems that Nick isn't the only one who can make mistakes. I'm afraid I'm going to disappoint you all.
So, what's this all about then, Graham?
Well, Beverly and Jim already know, but I wanted to go through it with all of you present.
Katie's still crashed. Do you want me to wake her up?
No, let her sleep. This is short, sharp, and very disappointing, especially for me. Yesterday I received a phone call from the Hong Kong solicitors handling Bess's estate. It was just a formality. They wanted to transfer the money into my account.
Wish I could get disappointing phone calls like that.
Yes, well, when they went through the details, I realized the mistake I made. When I first heard about the inheritance, the sum mentioned was $150,000. I took it for granted that they were talking about Australian currency.
Hong Kong dollars.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, boy. Why, the current exchange rate, that's...
Yes, I'm about, $130,000 poorer than I thought I was.
$130,000 bucks. You worried about $500.
Shut up. I'm sorry, that's terrible. I'm human enough to be sorry for myself.
But, Graham, you've already spent how much?
Well, enough to cancel out the amount I'll actually get, so there's almost nothing left.
Does that mean I won't get my bike?
Todd?
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, Todd, I'm sorry. No, there won't be a bike and Katie won't get her pony. That's what hurts most. I can't give any of you the things I promised.
Oh, come on, Graham, it's all right. Now, don't worry about me, Helen. I mean, I'd look stupid hacking out of the rough with a new set of golf clubs.
No bike. What'd you miss out on?
Just a headstone for Grandma's grave.
I thought he wanted something for himself.
Like all the rest of us.
Well, how about this? We just add one more word to the design. See?
Dessert Ratses.
Right. You spell rats with two S's, the same as dessert has two S's. Well, it's funky.
Funky, yeah. Look, I can tell you what Gail's going to say. Forget it with two T's.
Oh, it's all my fault. How come?
Nick only stuck around to protect me from Skinner, even went back to school. If I hadn't been so stupid and so irresponsible, he'd still be up north making heaps of money.
Well, since you've owned up, you can pay for the T-shirt.
Nick, you weren't supposed to hear that.
Don't worry, Sharon, I'll cop the bill. I'll probably still have to go up north to pay for it all anyway.
I've been trying to think of something to do with these T-shirts.
I know what I'd like to do. Drive up the bay and chuck the whole lot off the top of Rocky Heads.
Can't do that. It's pollution.
Well, you don't have to rub it in.
Sorry. I didn't mean it like that. Look, I don't think Gail's going to make you pay. I mean, you'd never do anything like this again. Not in 100 million billion years.
Sharon, you're a genius.
Me?
Anybody ever calls you an airhead again, they'll answer to me.
Who called me an airhead?
Henry, what are you on about?
The blonde bombshell has come up with the perfect solution, but I will need a hand.
Oh, your solutions are usually worse than the problem.
Yeah, I'm in enough trouble already, mate. I don't need more grief.
Nick, do you want to be off the hook or not? Hmm? Do you? Hmm? Trust me.
Julie.
That was Lucy. Julie already knows. You know, I think they're more upset for me than for themselves.
Well, we all feel that way.
Well, that's the family toad.
How did Hillary take it?
Well, I'll still give her the money I said I would. $20,000. Still, I intend to honor the promise.
That about cleans you out, doesn't it?
You know, I think Hillary deserves the money more than any of us. Can you imagine what she'd be like if I reneged now? Are you off?
Yeah, I'm running late already.
Oh, could you give me a lift, please, Jim? There's time to do some shopping before the bank opens. You know what really broke my heart this morning? Nick.
Yes. You got us all feeling a bit guilty.
Yes. The mail's in. Already? Have you noticed that the mail's always early when it's full of bills and more begging letters?
Yeah, well, you have to put up with a few more of those for a while.
Yes, and when they got there, the cupboard was bare.
Don't touch that, mate. It's Daddy's work stuff. It's what pays the bills, huh?
Hang in there, Dad. Bronnie's on her way.
Oh. Nervous about the exam?
No. No, I never thought I'd say this, but I can't wait to get back to teaching.
I can't wait till Jamie learns English.
Hey, have you had a blue with Paul?
No.
Well, it's just, I asked him where you were at the party and seemed really short about it, you know.
Yeah, well, I tried to make it, but couldn't be helped.
Oh, just in the nick of time. Jamie's got Des bluffed here.
Oh, wouldn't be the first time. Oh, good luck with the exam.
Oh, thanks. See ya.
See ya.
See ya, mate.
Tiger, breakfast time for you.
And clean up time for Daddy.
Oh, Des, is it all right if I leave Jamie at the crèche for a while today?
Oh, yeah, I suppose. Is there a problem?
No, not really. It's just something I've got to do, that's all.
Well.
And I've been thinking of dropping back to part-time. For Jamie's sake, more than mine.
He thinks the world of you.
But he's too old to be stuck with me all day. He should be with other kids. Just for a couple of afternoons a week, it'd be good for him.
Yeah, you're probably right. As usual. Just so hard to know where he's up to, you know? When you're on your own, you've got to make all these choices. Spend half the time dithering, the other half wondering if you made a mistake.
You're not on your own. You've got Mike here.
You know what I mean.
Sure. Don't worry. I'm not going to walk out on Jamie.
Oh, terrific party last night. Oh, sorry, you're busy?
I might be. You've got that look on your face.
An offer you cannot refuse.
No.
Oh, you haven't even heard it yet?
I was trying not to waste your time, but I guess you're going to tell me anyway.
Yes.
I could always call security.
You've got 60 seconds.
Space outside, a trestle table, some decent decos, and I'll get rid of those faulty T-shirts for you in 48 hours.
Nick's T-shirts?
At a profit.
What's the catch?
No catch. Maybe some whiting.
Henry, if you're planning some El Weirdo promotion with belly dancing or mud wrestling...
Do you think I'd lower the standard of Lassiter's? Do you honestly think I'd bite the hand that keeps rehiring me? Come on, Gail, give me a break.
Okay.
Oh, thanks.
Hi, Mr. Robinson.
Lunch is on me, you two. I could use the company.
Fantastic. We're going to share a cheese roll. Is Mr. Bishop around?
He's in the kitchen.
I'll just be set.
Sit down, Nick. I wanted to talk to you about this morning.
Oh, I'm sorry. That was my problem. Just kept my mouth shut.
It was a really nice gesture. It made our wishes sound a bit tacky.
Now, if I really loved her, I would have got her a decent headstone.
Oh, it's not a matter of love. Like everything, it boils out of money.
Should have saved enough by now.
You will eventually. Listen, why don't you go down and choose a headstone and let me pay for it?
Oh, thanks. It's not right.
Your family. That makes it right. And if you feel like paying me back later when you're a bit more flush, well, that's up to you.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Reception was empty.
Oh, James, at lunch, mate.
I owe you both an explanation.
What for? Nothing comes to mind.
Come on, mate. I played hooky at your party yesterday.
Des, what you do with your own time is entirely
up to
you.
Will you let him explain?
Jane was the reason. She'd rather not see me at the moment. I don't much blame her. I would have said something yesterday, but I didn't think it was fair to involve mates.
Oh, Des, I'm sorry. Things are a bit sticky, mate. But I've got to admit I am relieved. Well, when your bank manager starts crossing the road, you do become a bit concerned, don't you?
Paul, your best friend is going through an emotional crisis.
Hang on. There's no crisis. For God's sake, don't say anything to Jane.
You know I wouldn't.
Anyway, Paul's right. Book the restaurant. Champagne's on ice. My treat. Show my support for the Robinson Corporation.
Free feed. We accept.
Now, just do me one favour. Don't go ditching the Pacific Bank for some offshore mob when you become rich and famous.
You got that in writing?
No, thanks. I see enough of your signature.
Oh, looks absolutely stunning on you. What do you say, Bron?
Oh, beautiful.
Thank you, madam. Genuine Australian art. Do enjoy the flight home.
There you are.
Genuine works of art, one-off, never-to-be-repeated specials. You may hang it in your wardrobe today, they'll hang it in the National Gallery tomorrow.
Henry, is all that really necessary? We're doing fine.
Got to get the message across, Bron.
Yeah, if we were selling used cars, maybe, but...
Girls, do you like that?
What's all this about? Mercedes is releasing a series of prints by exciting new Australian artists. These are Nick Page originals. You'll notice the unfortunate mistake in the spelling. Unfortunate for us, but fortunate for you, because this is a collector's item.
Oh, yeah.
Do you know how much the 1930 pennies worth today? The penny postage stamp, Paul Keating's first calculator. This shirt, my friend, is an investment.
How much?
$10 and it breaks my heart.
You can leave all that art stuff for your tourists.
Bag, Ron!
Bag!
But if this T-shirt can look as good on my missus as it does on her, I reckon it's a good buy.
Thanks very much. Thanks.
Well, there's art lovers and there's art lovers. Oh! Interest you in a T-shirt, madam, sirs?
Oh, Gail, you told me and I wouldn't believe it now.
Believe this, funksters. Box, Bron!
Ta-da!
Oh, we'll be gone by lunchtime tomorrow. We could have sold twice as many.
Well, you better tell Nick to get cracking on the next line.
Nick's back in business.
Well, I don't have much choice, do I? He's already made me money.
Great! Oh. How do you feel about 1L in Billabong?
Henry, no.
Ah, just a thought.
A biting the hand that keeps rehiring me.
Did I say that?
Quote, unquote. Oh. You're back on at the Waterhole tomorrow.
Are you serious?
I never joke when I'm being taken out to lunch by two incredible hunks.
Oh, well, neither do I. Oh, I got my job back.
Yes.
It's a cuddle. Oh. Oh.
I feel like I'm wagging school.
Oh, come on, you ran out of patience. And you're entitled to an early mark. I'll put the kettle on. Helen will be in there. Helen?
Oh, sorry. You all won.
Just those begging letters. How much does this one want?
$20,000.
You've got to be kidding. Fancy asking for that much.
They're not asking this time, Jim. They're demanding. And they're threatening the safety of our family if I don't comply.
That's about what you expect these days. Always some practical joker out for kicks, trying to scare people.
Well, frankly, it scares me. How do you know it's a practical joke?
Well, it's obviously kids. They see that sort of thing on television every day.
Well, I don't think we can afford to dismiss it out of hand. There are enough lunatics in this world. And if we do ignore it, well, we could be putting the kids in real danger. Exactly.
What's got into you two? It's just someone's idea of a joke. What does it say exactly?
Mrs. Daniels, you've got money and I haven't. That doesn't seem fair to me. You'd better send $20,000 addressed to 14 Hillview Crescent, Anson's Corner. Then maybe there won't be any nasty accidents happen to your cozy little family. Do we understand each other? I think we should call the police.
The Erinsborough News should never have printed the story. I'm surprised they had more of these. You know, we're going to look pretty silly if it turns out to be a 13-year-old having a go at us.
Oh, Jim, years ago I would have agreed with you, but I can't believe that anyone in Erinsborough would do something like this.
The way things are today, we have to take it seriously.
I agree with Helen.
We can't allow ourselves to panic every time someone with a twisted sense of humour tries out a practical joke on us. But if it'll make everyone feel happier, why don't we just keep a closer eye on the kids?
Ah, we can't watch them 24 hours a day.
All right, look, I'll check out this address. I bet it's just some kid with a vivid imagination and not much common sense.
Well, I suppose it's worth a try.
Stop worrying. I'll get to the bottom of this. And I'll do it without the help of the police.
So what I'd like to do, right, is get the last part of Mr. Mamoni's interview and put it towards the end of the article, which will balance everything out.
Yeah,
what do you reckon?
I agree. I'll just tell Dad where I'm going.
Right, I think I'll wait in the car. Bye, Mr. Skouros.
I'm going out for a while. Don't wait up for me. I'll probably be late.
And this is all you got to say? Don't wait up. I'm going to be late? You don't think I got a right to know where you're going or how late you're going to be?
Dad, Scott and I are going to work for a while, then we're going over to Jane's house to have dinner and watch videos. That's all.
Poppy.
I have to go, Dad. I've got a lot of work to get through. Bye.
I wonder if Paul and Gail have left the office yet. They said they're going to work back a bit and then go out for tea, but I bet they're still working.
Henry, I'm sorry, but I really don't have time to talk. I've got to have this assignment finished by Friday and I'm way, way behind.
Sorry. Righto.
Well, I'm putting my strings on.
Then can you do it a bit more quietly, please?
Sorry.
Oh, and can you keep these gardening voices somewhere else? Short enough working space as it is.
Yes, right. Oh, my fault entirely. I don't know what I could have been thinking of leaving them on the desk like that.
Actually, some of these are getting a bit overdue. Time I started pushing for payment, I think. Ah, the Andersons. Now, there's someone who always pays up no problem. Terrific people, especially Liz. You don't know Liz, which is a lot of fun. I always enjoy doing the garden because you...
I'm trying to concentrate.
Sorry.
And don't go pulling faces behind my back, thanks.
Oh, I knew it. Now, that is what I call a movie.
Yeah, happy ending for once. Joe, be sorry you missed it.
Oh, no, I'm sure he's having a great time at the pub with his mates.
Well, I thought it was great.
Just what I needed to help me unwind from today.
Oh, yeah, you test. I forgot about that. How'd it go?
Oh, pretty good. Not bad. And today was my last exam.
So now you're a fully-fledged teacher?
Well, I know I shouldn't talk before the results, but I reckon it's pretty much a formality now, yeah.
Terrific.
Yeah. Congratulations.
Anyway, how's your project going?
Well, it's not too bad. We did an interview this afternoon. Except my assistant here, who volunteered to take down the notes. And then, when we got back home, I found out that she'd done them in Greek.
I did not.
Well, I hardly even read a word.
Just because you're so used to that rat-scratch shorthand of yours, I could read it without any problem.
I've got an idea. How about before we put on the next video, I make some popcorn?
Oh, please. Mm-hmm.
Okay, back in a sec.
I'll give you a hand.
Good to see Jane starting to cheer up a bit.
Yeah, well, she's not the type to stay down for too long. I reckon she'll be back to her old self in no time.
Yeah, well, I hope so.
I thought you were the Pixies by now. Is the TV too loud?
No, I just couldn't sleep. Just been checking on the kids.
Oh, Helen, this threat business has really got you worried, hasn't it?
Yes, it has. But the more I think about it, the more convinced I am that it isn't a joke. We have to do something.
Well, I checked out that address. It's just an empty house. There's not much more we can do.
Yes, there is. Jim, I know you don't think it's serious enough to call in the police, but I do. I don't want to go against you, but the letter was addressed to me, so I think I'm the one to decide what to do. So I'm calling them first thing in the morning.
Well, if you feel that strongly about it, there's not much we can do about it.
Well, maybe Helen's right. If we don't call them and something happened to one of the kids, we'd never forgive ourselves. And at least this way, we'll be able to put our minds at rest.
Yes, it'll be a start. But my mind won't be at rest until the person who sent that letter is caught.
Okay, Jamie, here comes the aeroplane. Get those big hangar doors open. Come on.
Let's use that trick for a while. He normally eats whatever I put in front of him.
Oh, he eats well up in front of him too. I just happen to get a kick out of it, that's all.
Well, as long as one of you are having fun.
We're both having fun, aren't we, Nipper? Eh? Eh? Late night.
Yeah, getting on a bit after we finished watching that second movie. The girls made popcorn and coffee and stuff. We started talking and joking, and next thing I knew, it was past 12 o'clock, wasn't it?
Looks like everybody had a good time.
Yeah, they did. Even Jane. You know, I helped her wash up at the end of the night. We got talking a bit. Now, it might take a while, but at least we're friends again. If I take it slowly, I think things might come together between us again.
Yeah, well, I always said you and Jane were meant for each other. I don't know why you broke up in the first place.
It wasn't my idea.
I'm glad things are working out for you. At least somebody's getting their life sorted out.
Oh, well, most people would say your life's pretty well under control, all things considered.
Yeah, I don't know. Sometimes I just wonder where I'm going. You know, with Jamie and the job keeps me busy. There's still... What? There's still a big hole there. I haven't got anybody to fill it.
Yeah, I know, but you will.
When I find someone, you know, like Penny, and it doesn't work out, I always end up just where I started from. Oh, I don't know. Sounds like I'm feeling sorry for myself, but... It's a bit down, you know, but Jane and Joe are crook at me. And Paul, I hardly ever get to see him these days. Seems like all my friends are just drifting away from me.
I thought you and Paul were best mates.
We are. But he's so busy, I hardly ever get the time to have a beer with him, you know?
Oh, well, it's only temporary. And hey, in the meantime, you've got me, your old mate Mike. Now, look, I know we had our rough patch over Jane and stuff, but that's all behind us. As far as I'm concerned, we're as good of friends as we've ever been.
Yeah, of course we are. Like I said, it's not as bad as I'm making it out. I suppose it's just a matter of getting out there and meeting a few people. Just finding the time and making the effort, eh?
You said it.
Come on, you little climber. Here we go. Aeroplane. Come on.
I dropped the kids off at school without an incident, and I told them to be very careful of strangers.
Well, they should be safe at school. Jim, do you have time to wait and talk to the police before you go to work? They should be here at any minute.
No, well, they're here already. I just saw them pulling up as I come up the drive, and I've already told Rob that I'm not going to go.
Hello?
G'day, Bill. Come in. How are you?
Jim, here you got a few problems, mate.
Yeah.
Oh, this is Constable Connors, Jim Robinson.
Nice to meet you.
How are you?
This is my wife, Bev, and Helen Daniels.
Hello, how do you do? Well, you obviously know each other.
Oh, we've played the occasional round of golf together in our time.
Just a few.
Mrs. Daniels, you're the lady I spoke to on the phone.
Yes, I am, Sergeant.
Well, we put the address you gave us to our computers, and the family apparently are away overseas on holidays.
Which explains why the house was empty when I went round there.
Yeah, by all accounts, they're a reputable family, so I think we can disregard any possibility that they're involved. It's much more likely someone who knew they were away and thought it was a smart idea to use their address as a cover.
Oh, so you don't think it could be just a practical joker?
Well, that's possible, but I don't think we'd catch them. No, if these people are out to actually take your money, then that gives us something to work on. Can I see the letter?
Yes.
Well, if you want my opinion, I'd do what they say.
You what?
Give them the money.
No, but we can make them think we are. Get an envelope, fill it up with bits of cut-up newspaper, and send it to the address they gave you.
But is that wise? If they see that it's only newspaper, won't they try to carry out their threat?
Before they can see it's newspaper, they have to collect the envelope, and we'll be there to collect them.
Well, I suppose if you think that's the best thing to do.
Well, it's always worked for us in the past.
How's it going? That's a little old for that thing now.
Oh, look who's talking.
Oh.
Hey, last night was lots of fun. We're going to have another video night soon.
Yeah, it was good. I noticed you're enjoying yourself. Poppy seemed to have a good time.
Yep, she sure was. She loves movies.
Look, I realise I'm probably going to get in trouble for this, but it seems a little obvious that you and Poppy like each other, you know?
Mike, we're good friends, that's all. Look, she's a terrific bird and we have great fun together, but that's it. There's nothing more to it, okay? I'm just going to go and see what Henry's doing. I'll see you later.
Jane.
Hi, Scott. Hi.
G'day.
Scott's in a good mood considering how late we were all up last night.
Yeah, he's been pretty bright since him and Poppy have become friendly. Haven't you noticed?
Well, I know he likes her, but I don't think it's anything more serious than that. I mean, well, I guess Scott needs friends. Must be pretty lonely with Charlene being so far away.
If it's friends he wants, he's got you, me, Henry, Des, any number of us. No, I think he's just becoming a bit too serious about Poppy and doesn't want to admit it to himself. And if that's not looking for trouble, I don't know what is.
No, I don't think it's that bad. I mean, sure, he likes Poppy, but he loves Charlene. There's a big difference. Anyway, I'm going to drop these videos back to the store, so see you later.
See ya.
Yeah, I heard you come and pick up some of your stuff from the house this morning. You're getting pretty unsociable in your old age, aren't you? I mean, there was a time when you would have come around, said g'day, hung around for an hour or two and put off doing your work as long as you could.
Not true. I did not get where I am today by being work shy, my friend. Besides, I didn't have time. Had to be over at Liz Anderson's place to do a father's lawn, and if I get there early enough, she makes me a terrific breakfast.
Oh, I offered to make you breakfast before. You said you weren't very hungry.
Yes. I must have worked up an appetite on the way over. I'm not saying Liz is a better cook than you or anything.
I don't think I know this Liz Anderson, dude. Does she live around here?
Or... Oh, a couple of blocks over. I'm surprised you haven't run into her. Oh, she's a real girl. A lot of fun. You'd love her. In fact, the best thing about Liz is her sense of humour. She always makes you feel like she's glad to see you.
If you two will excuse me, I'm going upstairs where I don't have to listen to never-ending stories about this wonder girl Liz. Maybe I'll be able to get some work done up there.
What do I say now? I don't know what's got into Bron lately. If you ask me, it's the strain of all this study getting to her.
Sounds like jealousy to me.
What?
Well, Henry, it's obvious that you think a lot of this Liz Anderson, but...
Well, sure I do. She's... Oh, I get it. You think... So Bronnie thinks... Well, wouldn't hurt her to be jealous for a while. Might start noticing I'm alive again. Oh! I've just given myself the most brilliant idea. Scotty, you're going to love this.
No, I'm not. I don't even want to know about it. Henry, I made a New Year's resolution never, ever to get dragged in one of your crazy ideas.
You don't have to.
Henry, you can find someone else, okay? Poppy's coming around to have a swim and I'll get her to get a bit of work done. Be sure she does. Bye.
See ya. This is the best idea I've ever had. I love it.
I'm going out for a while, Dad.
Che passo, Ligo? E ci vieni?
Speak English. You need the practice.
Ama po sexo?
English.
You dress decent.
This is decent. It's 20th century, you know.
I know what century it is. When I read the paper, I see what century it is. Every day, young woman attacked by gang of louts. You dress like that, you're gonna get in trouble.
For heaven's sake, I'm only going over to Scott's for a swim.
This married man again. You see him last night. You see him this morning. I tell you, you spend too much time together.
Look, it's my time. I'll spend it with whoever I want, okay?
Why not Stavros? He's not married. You know him all your life. And he's a good friend.
Once and for all, I'm not interested in Stavros. Not the way you want. Well, we should stop going on about it before we get into a serious argument.
Oh, Poppy, I just want you to be happy, that's all.
I know you mean well, Dad. But the fact is, I'll never be happy if I marry someone I don't love. And however much you want, you can't tell me who to love and who not to.
You're saying you love this Scott Robinson?
No, I didn't say that.
He's a married man, Poppy. I don't want to see you hurt.
Let's just stop talking about it, okay? I have to go.
Well, we've done what the police asked. The envelope's on its way. All we can do now is see what happens.
Yes, but it's going to be difficult to have to sit and wait for it to be delivered. I'm starting to wonder if it might have been better to have sent the money.
Oh, no way. You can't give in to these people. Otherwise, there'll be another letter next week asking for another $20,000. Or $50,000. I mean, there'll be no end to it. Handling is the only way we can. That is, assuming, of course, it's not a hoax.
But what if the police don't find them and they find out that we've tricked them? There's every chance that they'll carry out their threat and go after one of the family.
It's not going to come to that, Helen. The police will find whoever it is. Now, let's just try and put it out of our minds and wait till we hear back from Sergeant Mooney.
Thought you'd locked yourself away to study all morning.
Oh,
Do I hear you volunteering to do the washing?
Well, you know, I'm no good at that kind of thing. Probably put in too much soap powder or something. Don't want to flood the place again.
Yes, well, someone has to do it. And I've got tech tonight, so let's do it now or not at all. If that's all right with you.
Sure.
Oh, information? Yeah, hi. Very well, thanks. Look, I'm calling from Erinsborough. Could you give me the number that makes my phone ring so I can check it's working okay? Right, got it. Thanks a lot. Bye.
It's okay, it's me, it's Liz. How you doing? Hey, thanks for that great breakfast this morning. You really are a terrific cook, you know that? Hey, don't tempt me. So, has your father got some more work for me, or has my luck finally changed and this is just a social call? The edges? Yes, I can do that. A couple of days or so? How about we make it first thing in the morning and you can feed me another wonderful brekkie? Want to be careful, Liz, I might take you up on that. Who says I'm joking? How do you think Romeo met Juliet, huh? He started off by clipping her bushes. Look, some of history's hottest romances started that way. Would I lie about something like that, Lizzie? Oh, Liz.
This article is coming along so well, I think I'm going to have to give you a co-writer's credit. I could never have done it without you.
All I've done is introduce you to a few people and act as interpreter. Anyone who's Greek could have done that.
Maybe. But they certainly wouldn't have made it as much fun as you have. And, of course, it's the company that makes all the difference. I'm glad you could come over.
So am I. Although coming to see you is starting to turn into a real hassle.
What is that?
My father. Why am I spending time with you when I should be off marrying Stavros and having lots of little Greek babies? I just can't seem to come to grips with the revolutionary concept that since I don't love Stavros, it's not a particularly terrific idea for me to marry him.
Well, maybe you should sit down with your father and talk it over with him calmly.
Believe me, it's not that easy.
Well, I can't understand how he's getting upset with me, though. Haven't you told him that we're just good friends?
I've told him. He just doesn't believe me. He says it's not natural for a man and a woman to spend so much time together unless they're more than just friends.
Not natural, eh? Well, that just goes to show how much he knows.
Maybe it does. Maybe he knows me better than I know myself.
How do you mean?
I mean when I see you just as a friend, someone to have fun with. Well, maybe it was true to start with, but not anymore. I think it's time to be honest with myself as much as with you. And the truth is, I'm in love with you, Scott.
Neighbor, everybody needs good neighbors. Just a friendly wave each morning helps to make a better day. Neighbors need to get to know each other. Next door is only a footstep away. Neighbors, everybody needs good neighbors with a little understanding. You can find the perfect blend. Another. That's when good neighbors